Hi, I'm Maureen Walsh, your state representative from the 16th Legislative District. The 2010 60-day legislative session began on January 11th. The news is not good, as I am sure you're aware, and even after balancing a massive shortfall last year, this year's supplemental budget needs to tackle a $2.6 billion deficit. Yesterday, the House heard the first of what may be several bills to increase taxes this year. However, I tend to be one of those folks who sees the glass half full and actually see this year as a major opportunity, not to increase taxes on hardworking employers and families who are already struggling, but a chance to make lasting changes in the delivery of state services and to hold true to our priorities. This won't be an easy year, and I'm telling most people my goal with this budget is to do the least harm. We will never get out of this situation if we don't get folks back to work. I have heard from many constituents that they'd rather be working than hearing about silly proposals in the legislature that lose focus of the fact that we have over 300,000 people in Washington out of work. I'm supporting a package of reform bills to help employers grow and expand jobs. One of the bills I'm supporting deals with privatizing the insurance system that helps injured workers. Did you know that we're only one of four states in the nation that has a state-run monopoly on workers' compensation insurance? The Department of Labor and Industries has reported that the insurance fund is not stable and wants to raise rates on employers. If we make the state compete in the market for a more efficient delivery of compensation for injured workers, employers will pay less and employees will be helped more. I hope we'll also be looking at some of the onerous taxes and regulations placed on employers. Employers can't keep people working when they're buried in bureaucracy. After all, it is employers who are providing the jobs we so desperately need to get our economy back on the right track. The governor said in her State of State address this week that tax increases must be part of the answer to the budget shortfall. But did you know that from February 08 through October 09, more than 8,000 new government jobs were added, while more than 170,000 jobs were lost in the private sector. I cannot, with good conscience, support tax increases on struggling families when state employees are receiving raises and pay just 12% of their health insurance costs. We really should take a closer look at benefits and salaries public employees receive to see that we are all taking an equal hit in these tough economic times. In closing, I'd just like to say I always appreciate hearing from you and welcome your ideas, comments, and feedback. If I can ever be of assistance to you in any way, please let me know by calling, writing, or sending me an email. Thanks for taking the time to listen today. It is an honor to be your state representative. I'm Maureen Walsh, and I'll talk to you again soon.